The only issue with Power Query and Pivot Table Summary Model is that Power Query cannot accept protected sheets. Since the source of our individual data are these prepaid sheets, as you can see here, they all are protected, right? We did a protection in our previous example where we discussed about simple formula based model, and at the end we added a protection to all the formula cells and kept open only few cells like this column E, column B, and this particular cell B3. But if you have protection in your sheet as a source data, Power Query cannot work with it. It will not accept any data from that particular source. In this particular case, we have to apply some form of protection, right? We cannot leave our template open for any kind of errors or any accidental formula deletion. One way around would be to use array formulas instead of simple formula. So currently we are having a simple formula, and we can add array formula especially for this prepayment monthly calculation, which is the key formula structure in an entire table, in an entire model. We'll try to update our existing formula to an array function, and I'll be copying this array function to entire model itself. And once it is copied, you cannot delete any individual cell or formula, you cannot even edit it. So let's start with that exercise. So we'll be starting with this cell G6 where our original formula is. Now we have to update this formula with array function. So what we have to do, we have to select arrays instead of individual cells. So in this case we have cell C6 selected, but we want to select entire array. So what is the array for C6? It is C6 to C65. And here the cell range C65, we have to make it absolute since we'll be dragging this formula down. Similarly, G5 is this particular cell selection. We want array of it. So what is the array? We have to select entire row. So we have to go till the end, till column BN, till BN5. And here as well, we'll be making this particular BNL cell as absolute reference with double dollar sign, right? Similarly, G5, again, we have to make it an array selection. So I'll be just typing BN5 and let's make it absolute value here, right? And column D6 again is similar to what we selected with C6. So we'll be just typing D65 and make the reference absolute. Similarly, app6 is our monthly charge, that also we have to select till 65. So app65, and let's make it absolute. Now usually we press enter after this kind of formula writing, but for array formula to work properly, you have to press Control Shift and enter. So I have selected from cell G6 till BN65, right? Now the formula which we wrote before, the array function here, it is available here, right? We want to apply this formula everywhere. So to do that, we have to press Control Shift Enter. And now you can see the curly brackets are appearing here. That means this is an array function. You cannot enter this particular curly brackets manually. It won't work. Excel enters this automatically and it tells us that this is an array formula. Now if somebody goes and try to delete this formula, it won't be deleted. Why? Because it's part of an array. But of course you can edit it with F2 key, but you cannot overwrite it or delete this formula straight away. Only way to get rid of this is to select entire field like this and press delete. This way you can add some form of security to your model structure, especially the key formulas which are prepayment amortization. This will work with Power Query without any problem because this is still not protection which we usually apply with sheet protection. I hope you have enjoyed this particular lecture. If you have any question, please let me know in Q&A section of this lecture. Thank you very much for watching. In next lecture, we'll be going through our advanced PBA model, which is more of a program. So I'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you very much for watching.